தனியிட ஏறிய சுளையும் முற்றல் களையிட ஏறிய சாரும் பனி மலர் ஏறிய தேனும் காய்ச்சு பாகிட ஏறிய ருசியும் நனிப்பசும் பொழியும் பாலும் தென்னை நல்கிய குளிரிள நீரும் இனி என என்பேன் எனினும் தமிழை என்னுயிர் என்பேன் கண்டீர். We welcome you all, sisters and brothers. As you know, we have assembled here for the function of the release of book written by our leader, Mr. Vaiko. And the name of the book is Yes, We Can. This book written about the history of emancipation of blacks and the emergence of respectable president of America, Mr. Barack Obama. We, on behalf of Mr. Vaiko, author of the book, invite Mr. Ganesamurthy MP to make the inaugural welcome address.
We welcome one and all of you for this gracious function. The very fact and important message is that this book was first written in Tamil and published well before respectable Barack Obama got elected as president of USA. This book, when published in Tamil, took the very valuable point is that Mr. Barack Obama will be and should be elected as president of USA. Even though Mr. Vaiko is not an astrologer by any chance, it is surprising that he could predict people of America will elect him as president of USA. The success of Mr. Barack Obama's victory became a reality of Mr. Vaiko's prediction. This capability and boldness of Mr. Vaiko's prediction on Barack Obama is one of the unique in nature and has to be appreciated by one and all of you. This book was written with a voluminous feeling and sympathy on downtrodden, which Mr. Vaiko had it in his blood and mind. Mr. Vaiko, my leader, brought this highly valuable book on downtrodden race, who have been in olden days treated not at all as human beings. This Mr. Vaiko could do because he is a really sympathizer of the downtrodden, who took lessons and had practical experience and massive inspiration he gained from the great leader Anna, the father of Dravidian culture. Mr. Vaiko is not only a revolutionary history writer, but also a creator of modern Dravidian history. I welcome Honorable Dr. Farooq Abdullah, Minister for New and Renewable Energy, Government of India, who will release the book. I welcome Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Punjab, Thiru Sukhveer Singh Badal, who will receive the first copy of this book. I welcome former Chief Minister of Haryana, Thiru Om Prakash Chautala, who have come to grace this and felicitate the book release function. I welcome Thiru Yaswan Singha, former Union Minister of Finance, who have come to grace the function. I welcome Mr. Honorable Thambithurai, former Deputy Speaker and Leader of AIADMK Parliamentary Party, who have come to grace the function. I welcome Sri Namma Narayana Rao, leader of Telugu Desam Parliamentary Party, who have come to grace the function on behalf of Honorable Sri Chandrababu Naidu. We welcome Sri Nanjil Sambath, Prabhakanta Secretary of our party, who is the program organizer of the function. Let me have the pleasure of welcoming one and all of you. You have come to grace the book release function. It is really a great honor for us, and we are all very much pleased to see all of you here. Thank you.
Now I have the pleasure of inviting Honorable Dr. Farooq Abdullah to release the book written by Mr. Vaiko, and would request Honorable Thiru Sukhveer Singh Badal, Deputy Chief Minister of Punjab, to receive the first copy of the book. On behalf of Honorable Chandrababu Naidu, former Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Mr. Nama Nakasro Rao, leader of the Telugu Desam Parliamentary Party, will deliver his speech on the release of the book.
Today, on this occasion, Chandrababu Naidu Ji, our leader, has to come, but due to the certain emergency, certain issues, certain developments, he is unable to come. And he sent the message that he is very close to Vaiko Sahab. Every time, every issues, when we are discussing also, he is mentioning Vaiko Sahab in our party internal meetings also. Vaiko Sahab is a great man. From the beginning of his student life, he has done a lot of things. He has struggled a lot. He has served for the people. And he has taken up a lot of public issues in his life. He is the person who is ground to earth. Say, he has gone to the common man. He has solved a lot of common man's issues. And as a member of parliament in the both the houses, almost 5 times. And he has served the nation and as well as the in the parliament, he has taken up a lot of national issues also and as well as Tamil Nadu issues. Several handicapped people he has given the treatment, operation, and a lot of things he has done, and the blood donation and as well as medical camps for the poor people. So he has done a lot of social service in the rural area and the poor for the poor people. So nowadays this is very important for the any leader or any person to contribute this social service. Really he is a great man. And apart from that, he has written several books in his life. He has gone to the jail for the public purpose. He has written this Yes We Can Do, the Yes We Can. Say that is the confidence level. And he has mentioned very history of the blacks. This contents has came from his heart. For the society, he has given the very good message in this book. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Behalf of MDMK party and Thiru Vaiko, I would extend my sincere thanks to Honorable Naman Amaheswar Rao. Now I would request Honorable Thiru Thambi Thurai, who is taking part as the representative of Madam Jayalalitha, former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, to deliver his speech in this occasion.
I want to convey certain message which my beloved leader has sent. That is why I come over here to represent our madam, that I want to read out the message and to give to him. Our madam has written, Dear Vaiko, racism in the United States has been a major issue ever since the colonial era and the slave era. Legally sanctioned inequality imposed by heavy burden on Native Americans, African Americans, Asian Americans, and Mexican Americans. White Americans were privileged by law in matters of literacy, immigration, voting rights, citizenship, land acquisition, and criminal procedure over periods of time extending from the 17th century to the 1960s. Personages like Abraham Lincoln and Martin Luther King led the struggle for emancipation of the downtrodden communities from the forefront and even paid for it with their lives. Racial discrimination came to be perceived as socially unacceptable and morally repugnant as well. Yet racial politics continues. While India, which is still frequently played by the world media for its pernicious caste system, has had people from the depressed classes adorning the highest office of government, including the presidency. It is only now that America boasts of its first black president, Barack Obama. I must congratulate you for having taken the time and trouble to chronicle the history of emancipation of the blacks of America through a book appropriately titled, Yes, We Can. A slogan that was immortalized during Obama's presidential campaign. Best wishes. Yours sincerely, our Madam Jayalalitha Ji. Thank you very much. It was, this is the message which our party, my leader, has given. I had to hand over to him.
I thank Thiru Thambithurai on behalf of Thiru Vaiko for participating in this function, and we are very much grateful to Madam Jayalalitha for deputing him to participate in this function. Now I would request former Union Minister of Finance, Honorable Yashwant Sinha, to deliver his valuable speech in this occasion.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am attending this function not so much as an admirer of Barack Obama, but as an admirer of Vaiko. You can see from the people who have assembled here that from the north to the south, from the east to the west, the entire country is represented on this occasion when Mr. Vaiko's book. So I don't know how relevant the slogan "Yes, we can" is in today's US, but "Yes, we can" is a very relevant slogan for my friend Mr. Vaiko, and I'm sure he can, and I'm sure he will. The rise of President Barack Obama in the US, his entry in the White House, has indeed been an epoch-making event. There is no doubt about that. And the manner in which he captured the imagination of the whole world, not only the voters in the US, but of the whole world when he was campaigning for his presidency, is something which is unprecedented. I don't think any other election, even in the US, created that much excitement about the result that this particular election did, from the time of the primaries of the Democratic Party to his winning the primaries and then to the ultimate election for the presidency. And if you link it with the history of the emancipation of the blacks that Mr. Vaiko has covered in this book, you will see how, but very, very gradually, things have changed over time in the US. Things change much faster in our country. You know, you, with one stroke of the pen in the Constitution, a whole lot of things changed automatically on the 26th of January, 1950. But in the US, it's been a long, long, long struggle. 200 years, as Mr. Farooq Abdullah is saying. And even today, we cannot say with confidence that the blacks in the US deserve what they ought to get. There is still discrimination. There is no doubt about it. And Barack Obama himself faced that discrimination, and even today he's facing that discrimination. I remember I traveled once to East Africa, some countries in East Africa, and there along the coast, a tourist attraction these days is the black holes in which they used to keep the captured slaves. They used to go pluck them literally from their fields, the farms, and the homes. They used to bring them to these black holes and keep them there captive until the ships came, and then bound hand and foot, they will be loaded onto the ships to be taken to the US. And then the life that they led in the US, I mean, the many books that Mr. Vaiko has quoted in this book would clearly demonstrate what was the kind of life that they were forced to live as slaves in the US until Abraham Lincoln emancipated them after the Civil War. But there is something of this which survives, unfortunately, in the US. Part of this cruelty is still there. Otherwise, there would not have been a Guantanamo Bay prison in the US if that cruelty has not survived. You know, Mr. Vaiko has been inspired by the columns that Anna used to write under the caption, "In the White House." And he has been inspired by reading those columns. I hope this book will be read by the Americans. I hope this book will bring about a mindset change in them. And I hope WikiLeaks or no WikiLeaks, the US will learn to behave better with the rest of the world. Thank you.
I thank Honorable Former Union Minister for his gracious presence and participation in memorable function. I would request Honorable Former Chief Minister of Haryana and President of Indian National Lok Dal through Om Prakash Sautala to deliver his felicitation speech.
ये उत्तर और दक्षिण का मिलाप है, पश्चिम और पूर्व का मिलाप है। बादल साहब का और वाईको जी का ताल्लुकात इसलिए ज़्यादा मजबूत है कि देश के आज़ाद होने के बाद ये दो ही व्यक्ति ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने बहुत लंबे समय तक जेल काटने का काम किया है। ये उत्तर की जेल में रहे हैं, बादल साहब दक्षिण की जेल में रहे हैं। इनकी एक बात के लिए भी समानता है, वाईको जी अपनी बात कहने में कभी संकोच नहीं करते हैं, कभी इन्होंने परिणाम की चिंता नहीं की है। हमारी अपनी सरकार में भी लंका के मामले को लेकर के तेलुगु पार्टी के लोगों के साथ जो जातियां हुई, ये वाहिद शख्स था जिसने इस बात को बुलंद आवाज़ में उठाया और उसके लिए हमारी सरकार के वक्त में भी इन्हें जेल की सलाखों के पीछे जाना पड़ा। ये अपनी बात कहने में कभी झिझक महसूस नहीं करते, संकोच महसूस नहीं करते, और यही आदत बादल साहब की है, वो भी अपनी बात कहने में कभी संकोच नहीं करते, कभी परिणाम की चिंता नहीं करते, इसलिए इनकी और अच्छी दोस्ती भी निभ रही है। वाईको साहब ये एक ऐसे व्यक्ति हैं जिनके प्रति अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी का अगाध स्नेह रहा है, मेरे प्रति और वाईको जी के प्रति अटल जी का अगाध स्नेह था और आज भी है। आपको जानकारी होगी कि जब पहली मर्तबा अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी प्रधानमंत्री बन रहे थे, सबसे पहले हम लोगों ने अलग रह करके और उनका समर्थन किया था, और उस वक्त समर्थन वाईको साहब ने हमने दिया था जब हमारे वोट बेल्ट बॉक्स में बंद पड़े थे, लेकिन हमने उस वक्त समर्थन देश के उज्जवल भविष्य के लिए उन्होंने दिया। और सरकार बनने के बाद अटल जी ने बहुत प्रयास किया वाईको जी के लिए भी और हमारी पार्टी के लिए भी कि हमारी काबीना में आप बर्थ लें। हम दोनों ने इस बात के लिए उनसे इनकार कर दिया कि नहीं, हम आपको प्रधानमंत्री देखना चाहते हैं, हमें पदों की इच्छा नहीं। उन्होंने यहाँ तक खुली ऑफर दी कि मैक में आप अपनी इच्छा के लें, कई मरतबा उन्होंने इस बात के लिए कहा, लेकिन हमने यही सोच करके कि एक अच्छे व्यक्तित्व के हाथों में देश के नाने हुकूमत होगी तो देश का भविष्य उज्जवल होगा, ये मेरे कहने की आवश्यकता नहीं। उस वक्त को और आज के वक्त को अगर हम तुलनात्मक दृष्टि से देखें तो आज हमारे देश की हालत सबसे ज़्यादा दयनीय है, और इन परिस्थितियों से देश को उबारने के लिए आज मुख्तलिफ विचारधारा के लोग जब यहाँ एकत्रित हुए हैं, अगर हम सब मिल करके प्रयास करेंगे तो निश्चित रूप से उसमें सफलता मिलेगी। आज जिस किताब को फारूक साहब ने रिलीज़ किया है, वाईको जी ने लिखा है, वाईको जी अच्छे लेखक हैं, इसके लिए मुझे बताने की ज़रूरत नहीं, लेकिन इस किताब के माध्यम से एक नई चीज़ जिसका असर अमेरिका में पड़ा, यशवंत जी ने सारा खुल करके बताया कि ब्लैक और वाइट की दूरी ख़त्म हो गई थी, कलर और कास्ट ख़त्म हो गया था, और उसी का परिणाम बिहार के चुनाव में आपने देखा कि वहाँ जाति पाति से ऊपर उठ करके लोगों ने इस देश में कांग्रेस का सुपड़ा साफ करने में अहम भूमिका निभाई। मुझे यकीन विश्वास और भरोसा है कि इस किताब जब ये लोगों के पास जाएगी तो बिहार के और इस किताब को जोड़ करके लोग अगले चुनाव में निश्चित रूप से कांग्रेस का सुपड़ा साफ करेंगे, तभी ये देश प्रगति करेगा। मैं यही कुछ आपसे कहना चाहता था। आप लोगों ने मुझे अवसर दिया, इसके लिए मैं आपका आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ और भगवान से प्रार्थना करूँगा कि वाईको जैसे बहादुर लोग लगातार संघर्ष में जूझते रहें, ताकि इनके संघर्ष से प्रेरणा लेकर के हम इस देश के उज्ज्वल भविष्य के लिए निरंतर प्रयासरत रहें। आप सबका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
आई थैंक ऑनरेबल त्रिवोम प्रकाश चौताला हु हैज ग्रेस्ड दिस फंक्शन एंड डिलीवर्ड हिज स्पीच। आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल त्रि सुबीर सिंह बादल टू डिलीवर द स्पीच।
Ladies and gentlemen, my father was supposed to be here today, but my mother is not well, so he had taken her to New York, and he called me up. I was in Punjab, and he said, Mr. Vaiko is like a brother and a family to him. The relationship between my father and Vaiko ji is stronger than even a blood relationship. Whenever Vaiko saab called my father for any political conference or a family function in Tamil Nadu, my father left every important work and has always been there. And whenever my father requested Vaiko ji, he left every important work and he has been part of our family functions. Today, again he called me up from New York to make sure that me and my wife are present here. I told him I know the date and everything, but he called me 2-3 times and he said, hope you don't get late, you have to be here. So such is the relationship. Like my father, Vaiko ji has also fought for a cause and has sacrificed his freedom for a cause. My father spent 16 years in jail, like Farooq Abdullah ji's father, after independence. And I've seen the whole country visiting my father in various jails. He spent 2 years in Coimbatore jail. I was just going to say that my father, like Vaiko ji and all the senior leadership here, have struggled for a cause and have sacrificed for a cause, and a younger generation like ours has to learn from our senior leadership how they sacrifice their life for the nation, for a cause. And yes, we can. It is a very important slogan. This clearly shows that if you are determined, yes, we can achieve the target. And it's a strong message that nobody ever thought that there could be a black president of US. Initially, when Obama started his campaign, people were not sure, they didn't give him importance. But the slogan, yes we can, yes we can. And I remember I was there during the elections in New York. Among all non-whites, there was a wave that we want to prove something, that yes we can. And at that time, even the white supported him, because there was a change. They wanted to prove that in America also that we can. But that's a message for all of us, and especially a younger generation, that if we are determined to achieve a goal, yes, we can achieve it. If we are determined to do that, I'd like to thank Vaiko ji to giving us opportunity. We are all with him. My father, our party, and everyone, whole complete leadership here clearly shows the complete country's love for such a person who's fought for the people and struggled for the people and sacrificed for the people. Thank you very much.
I thank on behalf of Mr. Vaiko, Honorable through Subir Singh Badalji, for making all the arrangements of this function and for his valuable speech. I would request Honorable Dr. Farooq Abdullah to deliver his address.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am a member of the UPA. All these fellows are members of NDA. But I'm here as a friend of Vaiko. I want to tell you, I have known him for years and years and years. I have seen his ups and I've seen his downs. But I've seen a fighter in him. He has never given up. Never, never, never. He would rather be in the jail than be enjoying outside for a cause. And that cause is still dear to him, let me tell you. One of the causes that is most dear to him is the Tamils of Sri Lanka. That has been his goal, to see that they get their due. I think all of us, whatever party we may belong, I'm sure, even as Foreign Minister of India, and as Finance Minister of India, Mr. Sinha, even then, there was always thinking of those people. And I think now it's vitally important that those people must get their rights. There is no question of forgetting them or forgetting that it never existed. They are still there. They have gone through tremendous pains. They have gone through rapes. They've gone through murders, but still they have not been able to bend them. And that is, Vaiko, that is your mission. Like you have said in that book is about America. And aptly, Sinha Saab gave you the entire synopsis in such a short and a right manner, that how over 200 years, slowly and steadily, we were lucky that we had Gandhi. Even today, if Obama is sitting in White House, one of the reasons is Mahatma Gandhi. It was Mahatma Gandhi's fight against the oppressor, started in South Africa, that Mandela came in and apartheid disappeared. Exactly the same way, the great president, Abraham Lincoln, gave his life for a cause of people who had no voice, who had no power. Obama is not yet out of the woods. He is on a trial stage. Will he succeed in turning the economy of America around? Or will he pay the price? Because there are a number of his enemies in that country itself. It's very difficult. Some of the whites have drunk this wine with great difficulty. They would have never wanted to see a black man in the White House. The tragedies the black have suffered. His book has been very cautious. But the truth of the matter is, they were slaves of such, they had no, nothing left, they had no soul, they had no life. They just existed. I hope to God that Obama is able to turn it around. While he's written a great book, and Yashwant Sinha said very rightly that he should release it in America, I hope he writes a book on India also. Because he has suffered also. My God, the amount of jails he has suffered. I remember my father's jail. When my younger sister was to be married, my father was in the prison in Delhi, wasn't released. And I remember the same thing. Badal Saab was in the jail and your sister was getting married. And those days the world was a little different. Today the world is a little different. And I came knowing fully well that there will be tremendous pressures from all sides. Because there are a lot of people in Delhi who fill ears. They will go around and say, oh, because they want to have their own broth. And that broth cannot be cooked unless they create differences. So there are Narad Munis everywhere, Narayan, Narayan. They're all over the place. I wish Vaiko Godspeed in his fight. May God keep you always young as you are. I don't know how you're so young. Yaar, hum budde ho rahe. I come from Kashmir where people, temperature goes down to -5 in Srinagar. And look, already I am in the Pheran, which is worn when it's -5. So already to me, Delhi is -5. Vaiko is still in that thing. And doesn't look a year older than Vaiko when I saw you 35 years ago. Kamal, main buddha ho gaya, ye bhi jawan ho raha hai. He must be taking some medicine, which I think I and Yashwant Sinha must find out from him so that we can also go younger. Well, anyway, God bless you. May you succeed in your mission and may we find a better way of working together for the sake of India. God bless you all and thank you very much.
I thank Honorable Farooq Abdullah for his effective emotional speech on behalf of Mr. Vaiko. Moolathin seelam kurayamal இந்த நூலை மொழிபெயர்த்த கார்த்திகேயன் அவர்களுக்கும் பொதுச் செயலாளர் சால்வை அணிவித்து கௌரவிக்கிறார். அரண் அமைத்து தந்து அயராது உழைத்த தம்பி அருணகிரிநாதனுக்கு போச்சலர் சால்வை அவர்கள் அணிவிக்கிறார். அச்சுக்கலையில் பல அத்தியாயங்களை படைக்கின்ற புத்தகத்தை அச்சிட்ட சிவகாசி குமரேசன் அவர்களுக்கு சால்வை அணிவிக்கிறார். இந்த நூல் மலர்வதற்கு தன்னை தத்தம் செய்து உழைத்த தம்பி பாடகலிங்கம் அவர்களுக்கு. நவ் திரு வைகோ ஆதர் ஆஃப் த புக் வில் டெலிவர் ஹிஸ் தேங்க்ஸ் கிவிங் ஸ்பீச். சிஸ்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரதர்ஸ், வணக்கம். டுடே இஸ் அன் அன்ஃபர்கெட்டபிள் மெமோரபிள் டே in my political life of struggles. I am deeply touched and moved by the kindest affection which has been showered on me by the beloved Chief Minister of Punjab, a great fighter for emancipation of the downtrodden, a leader who has spent most of his life more than Aung San Suu Kyi next to Nelson Mandela, that is Honorable Prakash Singh Badal. I don't know how I got his immense affection towards me. Mr. Dinsa is here. The frontline leaders of Shromani Akali Dal are here. The former Chief Minister of Haryana, Honorable Om Prakash Chautala, is here. I had the privilege of meeting Dr. Farooq Abdullah
as a member of parliament, the Lok Sabha, we had been together to the East Asian countries. I told him my wish, you kindly take me to your father, for whom we have got the greatest respect, the Lion of Kashmir, Sheikh Abdullah Ji. He took me. The appointment was fixed for me for 10 minutes. We entered his official room. The Lion of Kashmir. When I approached him with our famous Kanchipuram silk shawl, come on, my dear young friend, come on. I never expected he would spare more than 50 minutes for me. He took me to the garden. He called Dr. Farooq Abdullah. We had a photograph together in my village house of Kalingapatti. I have got that photograph as a valuable treasure of my public life. When I met Honorable Yashwant Sinha Ji about this function to release the book, he told me, definitely I will come. I recall, he came all the way to Chennai to release the book of my parliament speeches under the caption, Clarion Call. I have earned the affection and friendship of leaders, the tallest leaders of India. The former Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Honorable Chandrababu Naidu, was very particular to attend this function. But due to so many sudden developments, political developments, he could not come over here. He deputed the leader of the Telugu Desam Party. I am so thankful to the General Secretary of All India Anna DMK, my beloved sister Purachi Talavi, for the kind letter of congratulations and felicitations. When I went to Chandigarh, I told Honorable Badal Ji, I want you to release the book in Delhi. Could you indicate a convenient date? Badal Ji told me, Vaiko, whichever date you want, I will come. During the parliament days, I want to conduct the function. Whether it would suit you, 30th November Tuesday, definitely. I never expected he would provide all the arrangements. He told me we would conduct the function in our Kapartala house.
This is our family function. You are my family member. He telephoned the resident commissioner when we were dining together over telephone. Vaiko is our family member. 30th November Tuesday, his book release function to be held at Kapartala House. We have to look after all the arrangements. I was moved to tears. He has attended all the functions we arranged in our political party, MDMK. Whenever we conducted the conferences, he traveled all the way. When the wedding of my daughter took place, he came all the way from United States with Madam straight to Chennai. The day Dr. Farooq Abdullah also was there. Mr. Jaswant Singh also was there. For my son's marriage, all they came together. He took me to Katkar Kalan, the place of valor and courage, the birthplace of Bhagat Singh. He took me to Wagah Border. He took me to the place where the memorials for Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru is built. Before hundreds of thousands of people, the valorous Sikh community people, he introduced me before them. I am a small man, a fledgling political party. But he introduced me before them. Vaiko is, I don't want to repeat the words he has said about me. That will be a flattery. But he said, he is conducting a party of discipline. He has got a volunteer corps. And when he asked me to address the gathering, I took the sand and the earth I took from Katkar Kalan, I kissed before them that earth. He has telephoned from New York here. He has requested the Deputy Chief Minister of Punjab how the arrangements are going on. This book under the title Yes We Can Yashwant Sinhaji described about the book. This book should be read by the Americans. In this book, I have narrated not only about Barack Obama. I have narrated, vividly described, the struggles, sacrifice, untold sufferings of the African people, of the black people, the struggle of Nelson Mandela. In the year 1961, on 27th May, when Robert Kennedy, the brother of John Kennedy, when he gave an interview to the Voice of America, he stated, there is no question that in another 30 or 40 years, a Negro will achieve the same position as my brother, who has achieved the position as the President of United States of America. He was ridiculed. Severe criticism appeared.
This happened in 1961. Robert Kennedy was assassinated after Martin Luther King was assassinated in the year 1968. In 2005, in a Democratic Party meeting, the wife of late Robert Kennedy, Ethel Kennedy, he introduced a black man to the gathering. This is Barack Obama, who is going to be the president of United States of America. In the year 1863, the Proclamation of Emancipation was declared by Abraham Lincoln on the first day of January 1863. In the same year, Abraham Lincoln, in the corridors of White House, he met that famous writer of Uncle Tom's Cabin, Madam Harriet Beecher Stowe. Are you the woman who has created the civil war in this country? That famous book of Uncle Tom's Cabin, I have written two chapters about that Uncle Tom's Cabin in this book. After 100 years, you kindly listen, kindly make a point. Just correctly after 100 years, 1963, on 8th June, after midnight, the famous writer Irving Wallace, who contributed the famous Nobel Prize, about the Nobel Prize, he told his wife and children, just now I have conceived an innovative idea to write a novel. In this novel, a Negro is going to become the president of United States of America. A black man is going to become the president of America. He titled the book as Man. In the novel, by force of circumstances, a black man, Douglas Dillman, becomes the president of United States of America, not by electorate, not by ballot, by force of circumstances. In the summit conference, the building collapses, the president of United States of America dies. Even before that, the vice president already was no more. In the same accident, the president of the House of Representatives, he also got killed. According to the Constitution, the next man is Douglas Dillman, who happens to be a Negro. He asks his son, what is your opinion? His son says, he will be impeached by the whites. In that book, the climax, I don't want to say here, the climax will move anybody to tears. Merely after 100 years of impeachment, another impeachment in the novel, in the fiction, happens. The book was released. When John Kennedy was there, he was taken to the Oval Office. He was taken to the bedchamber to see the entire White House. He received threatening calls. Irving Wallace was severely criticized for the fiction, for the novel. And his son, David Walesinski, in 1999, when he gave an afterword for the latest edition, he has described, we got threatening calls every day for the book because my father described a black man occupying the Oval Office. And one day, the man who threatened, he nearly approached our house. The danger was coming towards our house. And my dad approached the police. With the assistance of the police, that man was apprehended. This happened in 1964. Our leader, the greatest leader of Tamils, Anna, the greatest Democrat, the disciple, the follower of Periyar. He wrote 11, 12 series of articles in his weekly about this novel, Irving Welles novel, under the title In the White House. You just imagine a fiction, a novel created such a volcanic hatred and opposition in the minds of the people in America. Because of this, after reading in the 60s, after reading the book Man by Irving Welles, after reading the book of, after reading our Anna's articles, when I came to know on 10th February 2007, Barack Obama, a young African-American, makes a declaration in Springfield, where from Abraham Lincoln contested, where from he gave the last speech before he went to the White House. A black man declares, I want to contest for the candidacy of the Democratic Party. You will be surprised to know leaders here, sitting here. On 8th March 2007, when the International Women's Day was celebrated, we conducted, our party conducted a seminar in the Soviet Cultural Academy. In that meeting, I said, a political miracle is going to happen. A black man is going to become the candidate of the Democratic Party. A black man is going to occupy the Oval Office of the White House. Many ridiculed. Many of my friends from US, they told me, what do you know about the United States of America? Only 12% blacks are here. Niggers, what do you know about America? I told them, let us see what is going to happen. The primary started. Every week, I was following CNN. I was writing in series of articles in my party paper, party weekly magazine. When Barack Obama, when he wanted to enter the Democratic Party convention in 2000, he could not enter the auditorium. But the very same man, Barack Obama, was invited by John Kerry in 2004. You have to give the keynote address. In 2004 in Massachusetts, in the keynote address of 17 minutes, when Barack Obama made the speech for 17 minutes, millions of Americans were moved to tears. Today, recession is there. Today, they are facing worst crisis more than 30s in the United States of America. But at the same time, reverses could happen. But he has achieved what nobody could achieve. He has achieved. In the Parliament Hall, in the Central Hall of this Parliament, he gave a speech for 36 minutes. 38 times he got the applause. He said, I am mindful of the fact that I might not be standing before you had not there been Gandhi. And in that speech he referred the poem of Rabindranath Tagore, where the mind is free from fear, where the head is held high. In that speech, he referred about Ambedkar, a position from where he comes, who is he? But a Dalit Ambedkar could pen the constitution of this country for the privilege, for the rights of the Indian people. 2008, I wanted to meet him. At that time, elections were not held. The elections were nearing. In the month of July 2008, I wanted to meet him in Chicago, where the frontline leaders of Democratic Party were there. I got the privilege of meeting him, and the official said, you should not talk to him, just you can shake his hands. But when he was coming, hugging everybody, the leaders of the Democratic Party, I just put one step
I am Vaiko, coming from India, the land of Mahatma Gandhi. That autograph is here. He gave the autograph. He said, to Vaiko, yes, we can. Not to me, to anybody. Anybody who has got the conviction, who could withstand the odds, who is committed for a cause, definitely he can win. And I was so happy the book was released in Tamil. Ananda Vikadan released the book. I don't want to enter into any political dialogue here. All my friends have come from any political parties. But sir, when the Tamil book was released, I was in the jail. I could not attend the function. But today, the tallest leaders of India have given the privilege of participating in this function to release the book. My brothers, the crusaders of our Dravidian movement, in many of the conferences you have attended, all more or less, all they have come over here. We are for a cause, for the cause of the downtrodden. When people are oppressed and suppressed, we fight for their emancipation. For the emancipation of Tamils, we are fighting. And it is Barack Obama who gave the call to stop the war, to bring ceasefire when the genocide was taking place against the Tamils in that island, despite the fact the organization of LTT was banned there. Therefore, today, again, I would like to express my deepest gratitude and thanks. I rarely come to Delhi. Very rarely I come to Delhi. But when I come over here, when I requested you, the very moment everybody, you said, we will attend the function. You have spared your precious time for this humble man. This will give more and more vigor to fight for the cause of Tamil people, not only Tamil people, for the cause of the people, whoever is oppressed, whoever is oppressed, we will fight for democracy. And that immense confidence is in our minds. I don't find words in my vocabulary. I don't find words in my memory to express my deepest thanks to all the leaders, all the dignitaries, for all who have come over here to attend this function in this cold winter of this year. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.